I love talking about the week on a Friday because it primes us for the week to come and it gives us an idea of what's been working. So let's get into what is working now. What's working now is bull riding. That's what's working right now. But just like a really good bull rider has to know how to hang on, we're going to talk about how to hang on to the bull in an environment like this. So let's start off with, you can see my notes there on the left side. So I'm giving you some insight into things that we are looking at, questions that I got in the closing session of today. And let me share with you all a little bit of what we've got going on and what I'm looking at for next week. First of all, in the Sector Secrets Mastery, we're going to take Disney, American Express, GE, and Chevron into the weekend. Now, I got some questions about things like Microsoft today into the close. And I said, you know, of all the things that I could trade in the XLK technology sector, Microsoft is probably not near the top of the list. NVIDIA, Salesforce, probably better, right? Is PANW something that I would look at in terms of a buy? No, I'd probably keep an eye on other stocks and sectors within the NASDAQ that are not gapping down and not participating in the overall uptrend, right? Walmart's a great one to keep an eye on. That's a relative outperformer in the XLP. Love it. Meta, Disney. Remember I mentioned Disney long? Meta or Disney, six of one, half dozen the other. You know, these are things we want to take advantage of. So my futures traders out there. All right, Rog, don't you trade futures anymore? Absolutely. Absolutely. What we want to do is focus on where the strength within NASDAQ is. Now, do we want to take advantage of NASDAQ? Yes. Let's talk about the most important thing first, right? It's overall moving higher. So you might say, Rock, how do you know that? Momentum and trend are bullish. Candles are almost exclusively green. Now, if I know that we're above the 200, green grab candles, bullish momentum, bullish trend dominating what's happened so far, you can see since the beginning of the year, right? What do we want to do? We want to buy, right? But where? That's always the challenge. Sure, we're going to have a couple of mean reversions, but you know what? Three entries throughout the past 2 months, I don't know about you, but I want more than that. So enter volatility levels. So mean reversions are price levels. These are price-based support levels, which are great, but not frequent, right? Volatility support is going to happen more often. It's going to give us quicker entries to get in and out. It's going to give us more frequent entries too. So if we balance the two, we're in good shape. Here's the difference between momentum trading and exhaustion trading. And what I do is exhaustion trading, gang. Exhaustion trading is buy the dip, right? And that dip can be, well, in this case, the mean reversion of the 34 EMA wave, right? But they also can be volatility-based support, in which case I'm talking about daily price movement ranges. Before today's up candle, take a look. Where does the green meet the gray, right? Where do the green candles meet the gray zone in a bullish environment? That's what we're talking about. Where does the green meet the gray? Rinse and repeat, yes? So if I like the NASDAQ, then I like NASDAQ uptrending stocks. The best two sectors continue to be SMH and XLC, and that's where things like Meta and Disney end up on the radar, right? And not only on the radar, but ultimately trades. Okay, what about the S&P? A lot of folks asking me about S&P. Now, whether you trade S&P futures, MES, SPY, SPX, the analysis is the same. Gorgeous uptrend. Where does the green meet the gray? Was the trade really today, or was it in the lead up to today, right? If we're sticking with consistency of our watch list, these opportunities are going to be far more frequent than chasing on this candle, right? And then that's where things like financials come into focus. Financials are generally moving higher where the green meets the gray. American Express, which is one of the positions we have, taking advantage of S&P strength, the financial strength, to ultimately stocks within the financials that are moving higher. This is bull riding, gang. This is how you, number one, find the trends and then hang on. Hanging on has to do with timing, right? Do I want to buy up here or do I want to buy here? Notice the difference. You might say, well, I'm buying an uptrend. Where we buy matters, right? American Express, do I want to buy after the move higher or do I want to take advantage of those days where seemingly American Express is, you know, what happens in a day like this? Oh, American Express is done, right? We want to buy the dip and dips never come on good news, right? So we prepare here, we prepare here, right, for those moves. And the Dow is really coming on strong. GE is one of the great stocks that are trending higher. We've got a position in GE that we've taken again and again. We want to do it every time the green meets the gray. And Dow is definitely in focus as industrials, financials, and now energy, XLE. One of our trades this week was Chevron. We not only have a swing trade in Chevron, but we had a gorgeous day trade today in Chevron as well. Keep an eye on these relative outperformers, gang. It is bull riding season. I'll see you in the next update. Hey traders, Raghee from Simpler Trading. Thank you so much for watching this video. Be sure to leave a like and a comment below. And remember, subscribe and click the bell icon so you'll get notified of the next update. And when you're ready to join me for live trading, be sure to head on over to simplertrading.com. I'll see you in the next update.